guess I'm going to walk. Oh, that milky white way. Oh, child, some of these days. Well, I'm going to walk that milky white way. Oh, some of these days. Well, 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 I'm going to walk up and take up my stand. Gonna join that Christian band. I'm going to walk, whoa, that milky white way. Oh Lord, some of these days I'm gonna tell my, oh, my mother, howdy, 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 when I get home. Yes, I'm going to tell my mother howdy when I get home. Well, 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 I want to tell my mother hey when I shake mother hand that day. That's when I won't. Oh, that milky white way. Some of these days. I want to meet God the Father and God the Son. Yes, I want to meet God the Father.
For his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For thy rod is with me. They comfort me. Thou preparest a table. Lord. his favor is life. Weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning. How precious in the sight of the Lord is the death of his saints. I will lift up my eyes unto the hills, from whence cometh my help. Cometh from the Lord, which made the heavens and earth. He will not suffer thy foot to be moved. He that keepeth thee will not slumber. Behold, he that keepeth Israel neither slumbers nor sleep. The Lord is thy helper. The Lord is thy keeper. The Lord is the shade upon thy right hand. Lord, you have been our dwelling place in all generations before the mountains were brought forth, or ever thou had formed the earth and the world. From everlasting to everlasting, thou art God. Thou returneth man unto destruction. Thou sayest, return. Day in thy sight is as a thousand years, days as yesterday, which has passed in a watch. In the night, to everything there is a season, a time, to every purpose under the heaven. And a time to die, a time to plant, and a time to pluck up that which is planted, a time to kill. embrace and a time to refrain from embracing. A time to weep and a time to laugh. A time to mourn and a time to dance. A time to give and a time to lose. Whatever you ask of God, God will give it. Jesus said, thy brother shall rise again. And Martha said, I know that he shall rise again and the resurrection at the last day. And Jesus said, I am the resurrection and the life. He that believeth in me, though he be dead, yet shall he live. And he that lives and believes in me shall never die. Believest thou this? Let not your hearts be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go to prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself. That where I am, there ye may be also. Where I go, you know, and the way, you know. Thomas said, Lord, we know not where you go is. And how can we know the way? Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. And no man come unto the Father but by me. And if you had known me, you should have known my Father also. From henceforth, you know him and have seen him. Philip said, Lord, show us the Father, and it suffices for us. Jesus said, have I been so long time with you, and yet have you not known me, Philip? He that has seen me has seen the Father. How sayest thou then, show us the Father? If this earthly house of this tabernacle is dissolved, we have a building of God, a house not made with hands, eternal in the heavens. Therefore, we are confident, knowing that while we are at home in the body, we are absent from the Lord. For we walk by faith and not by sight. We are confident, I say, and willing rather to be absent from the body and to be present with the Lord. Wherefore we labor, that whether present or absent, we may be accepted of him. We must all stand before the judgment seat of Christ, that everyone may receive the things done in his body according to that which he has done, whether it be good or bad. If Christ is preached that he rose from the dead, how say some among you, there is no resurrection of the dead? If there be no resurrection of the dead, our preaching is in vain. And your faith is in vain. If we believe not that Christ rose from the dead, and we are false witnesses of God because we testify that God raised him up. If Christ be not raised, we are yet in our sins, and those that sleep in Christ are perished. If in this life only we have hope, we are of all men most miserable. By man came death, by man came also the resurrection of the dead. In Adam, all died. Even so in Christ, shall all be made alive. Behold, I show you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall all be changed. In a moment, in a twinkling of the eye, the trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall be raised incorruptible. For we shall all be changed. For this corruption must put on incorruption, and this mortal must put on immortality. When this corruption shall have put on incorruption, and this mortal shall have put on immortality, then shall come to pass that saying which is written, death is swallowed up in victory. O death, where is your sting? O grave, where is your victory? But thanks be to God that give us the victory through our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. I heard a voice saying to me, write, blessed are the dead which dieth in the Lord. from henceforth, yea saith the Spirit, that they may rest from their labor, for their works do follow them. Though the youth may faint, and the young men may utterly fall, but they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as an eagle. They shall walk and not faint. Run and not grow weary. Thank you.
let's give God a hand clap of praise. Come on, we can do better than that. Let's give God a hand clap of praise. The Bible says, let everything that has breath praise the Lord. We're here for homegoing services for Brother Tavis Haugabrook. Saints, Tavis is in a good place. You're gonna miss him. Hold on to your memories, hold on to his laughter, his love, and his legacy. But he's in a much better place than you and I. The family has outlined a program that we are going to follow. And we're going to ask if your name is on the program to please be close by so that we can keep services moving. I'm going to come back before we do the, we allow reflections, because the family have spelled out here on the program that they only want four people to speak for 2 minutes. Now, I was not good in math, but I do know four people speaking for 2 minutes is 8 minutes. And we are going to respect the family's wishes. And let me say this. I want everybody to look at the program. And if you don't see your name, there's a reason why. That means the family didn't want you on the program. So let's respect the family's wishes. It's hard enough for them having to grieve. So let's not turn this into a showcase. Let's respect the family's wishes. Let's get ready for a prayer of comfort. After that, Old Testament, Deacon Clark is here. New Testament, Brother Robinson, please be close by. I come back with reflections to make sure that we understand that it's going to only be four people for 2 minutes. Brother Davis is here. And certainly yours truly is here to give the eulogy. Let's bow our heads for a word of prayer. Eternal Father, you are the maker of all things. You created us. You made us. You know all about us. We come now, standing in the gap between the living and the dead. Look into the hills from whence cometh our help. Because all of our help, Lord, it comes from you. So we come now, asking that you look down on this family. We lift them up to you, because we know you got all power in your hands. And Lord God, there's nothing too hard for you. And we thank you right now. You are a God of grace. You are a God of mercy. And Lord God, I pray that you lift up drooped down heads. Let this family know that they can cast all their cares on you, because you care about them. Lord God, we thank you right now. You said in all things that we ought to give thanks. You didn't say be thankful for all things. But you said in all things that we ought to give you thanks. And Lord, I come thanking you right now, because it could have been and it should have been the other way. But you have saw fit to keep us here one more day to give you some praise and to give you glory. Lord, I thank you right now that we are here. We are on top of the dirt, and the dirt is not on top of us. Lord, I thank you for that. And I thank you for watching over us all last night while we slumbered and slept. And then early this morning, it wasn't the alarm clock. It wasn't the children that woke us up. But Lord, you touched us, and you allowed our eyes to become open and to behold the dawning of a brand new day. This is a day that you've made. And Lord, we're going to rejoice and be glad in it. I thank you, Lord God, for Brother Haugabrook. But Lord God, I know there's nothing we can say to bring him back. But I thank you, Lord God, that we're still here. Looking to you right now. Lord God, we need you. Please move and have your way in these services. You're too wise to be foolish. You're too strong to be weak. There's nothing too hard for you. So Lord, look on this family. Wipe tears from their eyes. Let them know that everything's gonna be all right. Hold them in the hollow of your hands. Keep them as the apple of your eye, because you said weeping may endure for a night, but if we can hold on to 12:01 a.m., joy will come in the morning. So Lord, thank you for this day. I thank you for Brother Haugabrook's life. I thank you for those who he touched, Lord God. I thank you for keeping him here. Lord, I thank you right now for allowing him to be here for as long as he was. But now he's translated from this life to the next. There's nothing we can say, nothing we can pray, nothing we can sing to bring him back. But we know that you're still God. You sit high and you're still looking low. Keep this family as the apple of your eye. Strengthen them where they're weak. Build them up on every leaning side. Then one day, we too must quit this busy walk of life. One day, we too got to go this way. And Lord God, when it's our time to come, help us to be able to say like Paul said, my departure is at hand. I fought a good fight. I finished my race. I kept the faith. Now there's laid up for me a crown of righteousness, not just for me, but for all those who love your appearance. Lord, have your way. Let us celebrate Brother Haugabrook's life. These are home-going services. This is not a funeral. Amen. Lord, we love you, we bless you, and we lift you up in the name of Jesus. Let every heart say amen, 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 and amen.
Our Old Testament scripture reading will come from Psalms 27, and it reads as thus. The Lord is my light and my salvation, whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life, of whom shall I be afraid? When the wicked, even my enemies and my foes, came upon me to eat up my flesh, they stumbled and fell. Though an host should encamp around me, my heart shall not fear. Though war should rise against me, in this will I be confident. One thing I have desired of the Lord that I will seek after, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to behold the beauty of the Lord and to inquire in his temple. For in the time of trouble he shall hide me in his pavilion. In the secret of his tabernacle shall he hide me. He shall set me upon a rock. And now shall mine head be lifted above my enemies around about me. Therefore I will offer in his tabernacle sacrifices of joy. I will sing ye praises to the Lord. Hear, O Lord, when I cry with my voice, have mercy upon me and answer me. When thou said, seek my face, my heart said unto thee, thy face, Lord, will I seek. Hide not thy face far from me, put not thy servant away in anger. Thou hast been my help, leave me not, neither forsake me, O God, for my salvation. When my father and my mother forsake me, then the Lord will take me up. Teach me thy way, O Lord, and lead me in a plain path because of mine enemies. Deliver me not over unto the will of thine enemies, for false witnesses are risen up against me, and such breathe out cruelty. If I had fainted less, I had believed to see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Wait on the Lord. Be of good courage, and he shall strengthen thine heart. Wait, I say, on the Lord.
There is no special word to David spoken. There is nothing to be said to soothe thy heart. There's a word on high that can heal. When I say family, it's not those in the middle, those to the left, those to the right. It's everyone out here. This is family. Scripture that is being spoken is the one where the man that loved us all gave it all. Jesus is talking to his people here. It's the 15th chapter of John. At the 8th verse, it says, "Here is my Father glorified, that ye bear much fruit, and shall ye keep, and shall ye be my disciples. As the Father has loved me, it says that so have I loved you." Right now, there's nothing with that else to be said. You know, there's a scripture that says that heaven has no sorrow that earth cannot heal. So we need to look to that hill where all those blessings come from, all the healing, all the hurt, give it to the man on high. I have to believe that. I will believe that. And to my sister, my nephew, my brother-in-law, and all my loved ones, this day too shall pass. We just need to stick together and be with each other. Your support comes from me. My support comes from you. I love y'all. Each and every one of y'all out here, I love you. Thank you for showing my family love.
Here's how we're going to do it so that we don't have no conflict out here. I want four people who are going to speak to come on up. Four people. Four that wants to speak, come on up to this mic so that we can do this quick, fast, and in a hurry. Four people. So the four, only four now. I'm seeing too many coming. I only need four people. Only four. You're not speaking? Okay. So who's going to speak? Raise your hand. I need speakers. Okay, we got one speaker. I got three more spaces up here. Come on, sister. Got two more spaces. Got two more. Got one more. Come on, one more now. Okay, here we go right here. So these are the four that's going to speak. Let's respect the family wishes, those of you who are going to speak. 2 minutes. That's 8 minutes total. Thank you.
Doing. Brooke, I think the family gave me too much recognition. Best friend, I want that. I want that. I was the best cousin. I was the one. If we got into it, somebody called me so I could knock them out. That's what I was about.
That's right, baby. That's
but I'm going to tell y'all the time about when we was here. Actually, it was a football game, high school game. So I called the play. Brooke usually lead first to just go sit up. This particular time, he come back to me talking about, "Hey, cuz, what I supposed to do?" So I'm like, "I don't know. You do it. You know, get open." So with that being said, he went back over. He did whatever. We ended up scoring a touchdown. So it just, I don't know. I got so many memories, but I'm going to keep it at 2 minutes. I'm not going to go down memory lane. But, hey, this is Joe, Loretta, everybody. Y'all know we're going to be there. It ain't gonna, nothing ain't going to change. Like, we're going to still be there. be with y'all the whole time. Debo wanted me to play this. This Jarte cutting up like always.
Hey, John. This is your
father.
You can call back when you can, son.
But we're going to miss him. We're going to get through this, though. All right, we're going to think about the good memories, and we're going to get through it.
Good morning, everybody. Not only did Jarte light the football field up, but the track field that y'all see around, he also lit that up too. My name is Ben Tavis Miller. This is my teammate, Kendall Hinn. And that was also my teammate, Jarte Haugabrook. And y'all know Jarte ran third leg, and I ran second leg, and Hint ran fourth leg. So Jarte shares a special moment in between both of us. 2010, my senior year, I got to depend on these two guys, one in the casket and one here, to break the record. Coach Barron, Coach Harvey, they come to and they tell us, hey, y'all time, y'all running times, y'all can break them. The record that we broke, my brother held 18 years ago, and I was able to break that, but I was able to break it because of him, because of this guy, and because Keith Munfrey running first leg. So we in these history books, and I just want to say we love y'all. We couldn't have did it without Jarte. Jarte's name is forever in these record books in the state of Georgia for Class A for 41.9 in the relay. And we just thankful everybody that came out here and showed some love and support. We love y'all.
Good morning. I'm Ja Tavis, auntie from Orlando, Florida. We was just here about 3 weeks ago, and this is unreal, unbelievable, but we had such a beautiful time. When I say a beautiful time, I mean a beautiful time. We never know when God is getting ready to call us, but He does. And we just have to thank God that the memories that we have, especially the last memories that we had. I don't know who all still so, who all can climb, or who all got wet. But we had a beautiful time. And he told me, Auntie, I'm coming to see you the next time I'm in Florida. Well, I'm back to see you, baby. And I love you. On April 21st, 1993, Jartavis was introduced into the world. Once he was introduced to the world, but he was also introduced to Spruce Lane. Once he was introduced to Spruce Lane, there was no going back. Jartavis became our baby. He was raised to become a young man, a fine young man. Since this happened on the first night, I have not heard one bad thing about Jarte. Only good things. Only how he made everybody laugh. How he kept a smile on everybody's face. At least he tried to. He established so many friends and so many loved ones. That's family there. Those are not friends, that's family. When he came on Spruce Lane, all these people became our family.
because they're now calling us auntie, uncle, papa, granny, mom. It's not Loretta, it's not Joe, it's not Teresa, it's not Nika, it's auntie, uncle, papa, granny, mom. Because that's what Jartavis lived by. After growing to become a fine young man, he became a father to his little princess, Jayla Jayari Haugabrook. So let me do a little bit of description of Jartavis. J is for joyous. He was always full of joy, and he kept people laughing, and he touched everyone that he came in contact with. A is for adventurous. No matter what it was, Jartavis was going to do it. Even if it was not safe, Jartavis was going to do it, just because he made it fun and funny. R is for radiant. He brought a ray of sunshine into everybody's life. Even if you didn't want it, you got it. T is for talented. He was full of talent. Then Tavis just spoke up here about he ran track, set a record. He played football. He helped the team accomplish some games. He also played football, basketball, baseball, ran track. And at home, he was fixing cars, fixing stuff around the house, cleaning the yards. But then he became a dog man all of a sudden, some kind of way. He became a dog man. A's were awesome. That was just him. Overall, awesome achiever. He was victorious. Whatever he put his mind to, he did it. And he succeeded in it. I is for inseparable. That's the hard one. He's gone, but he's not replaceable. Nobody can take the place of Jartavis. S is for silly. He kept everybody laughing, whether it was him janking on people or him just simply walking in the room. If you were having a bad day when Jartavis walked in that room, oh, it was all over. Because the only thing he had to do was give you a certain look and everybody was just going to light up. He was going to blow the room up. And then you automatically knew, oh, it's about to go down. So for everyone that encountered something with Jartavis, something, someone, somebody, anything, please allow his legacy and his memory to live on forever in our heart. He cannot be replaced. He is missed dearly already, and he shows us love. We thank you all for everything. We love you all. Debo, Tone, Tank Head, all y'all, we love y'all. We're here. Those are our boys, those are our nephews, those are our sons now. So let the memories, his legacy live forever in your heart, and may the life he lived continue to speak for him.
Now I know the meaning of
love. I'm leaning on the everlasting arm. Oh, oh, if I can see it, then I can do it. If I just believe it, there's nothing to it. I believe I can fly. I believe I can touch the sky. I think about it every night and day. Spread my wings and fly away. I believe I can soar. I see me running through that open door. I believe I can fly. I believe I can fly. Oh, I believe I can fly. Oh, yes. See, I was on the verge of breaking down. Sometimes silence can seem so loud. Cause I know I must achieve, and I know that it starts inside of me. Oh, 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 if I can see it, then I can do it. If I just believe it, there's nothing to it. I believe I can fly. I believe I can touch the sky. I think about it every night and day. Spread my wings and fly away. I believe I can soar. I see me running through that open door. I believe I can fly. I believe I can fly. I believe I can fly. If I just spread my wings, oh, I believe I can fly. I believe I can fly. I believe I can fly. If I just spread my wings, I'm gonna fly. I'm gonna fly high. I'm gonna fly high. I'm gonna fly high. I'm gonna fly. Oh yeah, I'm gonna fly high. Oh, I'm gonna fly high. So high I can touch the sky. I believe I can.
The Book of Mark, Chapter 8. Just a few verses. The book of Mark. Chapter number 8, for those of you who have your source with you, beginning at verse 34. And when he had called the people unto him with his disciples also, he said unto them, whosoever will come after me, let him deny himself and take up his cross and follow me. For whosoever will save his life shall lose it. But whosoever shall lose his life for my sake and the gospel's, the same shall save it. For what shall it profit a man if he shall gain the whole world and lose his own soul? Or what shall a man give in exchange for his soul? For a few minutes,
I want to talk to family and friends from the subject, don't put it off. Don't put it off. Some of you been putting stuff off 10, 15, 20 years. Because some of you think that you got the rest of your life to live life. But I come to tell you, family and friends, we don't know where death is. I don't know how I'm going to leave here. But one thing I do know, we all got an appointment with death. One day you and I got to lay vertically in front of family and friends. In other words, it's time for you to get your house in order. Some of you have been wilding out for years, thinking that, well, I will get right when I get old. Who's to say you gonna get old? Who's to say that you are promised tomorrow? Some of you have already made plans. You know when you plan to get in church. You know when you plan to get saved. But how do you know you're gonna see tomorrow? Because here's what I know. I know how far I've come, but I have no idea how far I'm going. So whatever you're going to do, you better do it while the blood is still running warm in your veins. Stop thinking you got the rest of your life to get right. How do you know that? I wish I knew tomorrow. I wish I knew the future, but I don't know. If Tavis was here, he would tell us, don't put it off. Don't put off tomorrow. What you can do today. Here's some things, saints, that you need to stop putting off. First thing is, somebody here, you need to apologize to somebody.
Yes, yes.
Somebody here, you've said some nasty, mean, ugly words.
Yes.
To hurt somebody's feelings.
Yes.
You know they were nasty. You know they were hurtful. But your pride won't let you apologize.
Amen.
But I come to tell you, don't put it off. If you need to make amends, if you need to apologize, do it right now.
Amen.
Don't think that you can do it later.
Amen.
Yeah, don't think that you got the rest of your life.
Amen.
That you're going to always be here.
Amen.
Yeah, do it while you can.
Amen.
And see, all of us have said some hurtful things.
Amen.
Some of you woke up cursing this morning.
Amen.
Some of you went to bed cursing last night. And you know you were wrong, but you're too proud, you're too stout-hearted
Amen.
To say, I'm sorry.
Amen.
But don't put it off. Don't put it off. See, when you live right and you do right, see, then if you lay down to die, people can feel good about where you are. But if you're wilding out in the streets doing this and that, and you die, and your family has no idea if you're in heaven or hell, then that's painful.
Amen.
So I'm here to tell you, don't put off apologizing. You better tell whoever it is you hurt. You better tell them I'm sorry.
Amen.
Don't think you can do it next year.
Yeah.
Don't think you can do it the year after next. If Tartavius was here, he'll tell you. Don't put it off. Here's another thing that you ought not to put off. Some of you need to let some stuff go. Let me say that again. Some of you need to let some stuff go.
Yes.
Yeah, they were wrong.
Yeah, they treated you wrong.
Yeah.
Yeah, they did you wrong.
Yeah.
But guess what? Walking around with hurt and anger and bitterness is not hurting them. It's hurting you. And I don't know about you, but I'm not gonna let nobody cause me to lose sleep over foolishness.
Right.
You better let it go.
Amen.
Don't put it off. You better let it go.
Amen.
And the third thing, and I'm getting ready to get out of here, that you need to let go, that you need to don't put off. You need to give people their flowers.
Amen.
While they're living.
Amen.
You need to tell people thank you.
Yes.
While you're living and while they're living. You need to tell people I love you while you're living and they're living. Because one day it's going to come where you're going to want to say I love you, but they won't be here to hear it. So give people their flowers while they're living. Don't put it off. Let them know how much you appreciate it. Young people, let your parents and your family know how much you appreciate it.
Right.
Some of you, you've been blessed with a good support system, a good family, good parents, good grandparents, and you are yet to tell them thank you. Don't nobody owe you nothing. Why do we think people owe us something? Don't nobody owe you nothing. And if somebody helped you, don't put off telling them thank you. Now, I got to get out of here. But in the text, Jesus tells us a couple of things. Jesus said, whosoever will, whoever come after him, the first thing you got to do, you got to deny yourself. Because see, one thing about us, we can be selfish. Yeah, we can be some selfish people.
Amen.
All we think about, I,
amen.
me. But
amen.
Jesus said, if you come after him, you got to put self on the back burner. You can't think about self. You got to think about, how can I help somebody else? Yeah, don't put that off. You better get behind Jesus today while you can. Some of you are straddling the fence.
What?
Some of you, in and out, in and out. You better get behind Jesus today. Because who's to say? This might not be your last day. I don't know. Today might be my last day. I don't know. But one thing I know, I got my business straight. I got my house in order. And if I leave here today, I know where I'm going. Do you know where you're going? Because there's only one or two places you can go to when you leave here. Either you're going to hell, where it's going to burn. You think it's hot now. Die and go to hell. Because one thing about this hotness, you can get out of this.
Yes.
But if you die and go to hell, you will spend eternity burning in hell. Who wants to go to hell when you're catching hell here on earth?
Yeah.
What in hell do you want? But if you want to avoid hell, don't put off today. You have a chance to get your life right today. You have a chance to punch your ticket because the other place is heaven.
Yeah.
See, that's where I want my home to be.
Yeah.
I want to be with Jesus when I leave here. I want to see my loved ones. If you want to see Tavis again, then you better get your life right with Jesus.
Yeah.
You better come over on the Lord's side. Come up out those streets and come over on the Lord's side.
Yeah.
Because Jesus said, if you come, you got to deny you, though. And that's hard. Because our attitude is, well, I got to look after me. If I don't, who's going to look after me? But that's not what Jesus said. Jesus said, if you want to come after me, you got to put yourself in the back burner. And don't worry about people. That's what gets me about us. We don't worry about people when we're up in the club. We don't worry about people when we're drinking that Cavassier and that Hennessy and that red wine and that white wine. We don't care about people. But when it comes to Jesus, all of a sudden now we become closet Christian.
in the closet and don't want nobody to know that you believe in Jesus. But Jesus said, if you deny me, I'm going to deny you. So since he said, you got to take up the cross, you got to pay a price. Because when you come over on the Lord's side, folks are not going to like you. Folks going to talk about you. But can I tell you something, saints? I got to go, Shannon. You can crank it up. Can I tell you something about people, saints? Here's what I've learned about people. People don't like you. I don't care what you do. But why are you worried about folks who don't like you no way? Why are you concerned about what somebody going to say about you when they don't like you anyway? But Jesus said, you got to be willing. You got to be willing to let some people go. You got to be willing to tell some people, I don't think I'm better than you. We just don't have nothing in common. You got to let some folks go, saints. Some of you are hanging around the wrong crowd. You're hanging around the wrong people. I'm here to tell you, you better get away from them, because if you're not careful, you're going to get caught up in the same trauma and the same mess that they're caught up in. So don't put this off. Don't put this off. Jesus said, deny yourself. Take up your cross and come after me. What are you chasing? Are you chasing dope? Are you chasing crack? Are you chasing prescription pills? Are you chasing a man? Are you chasing a woman? But Jesus says, if you're going to come after me, you got to let some stuff go. You got to let some people go. Because what shall it profit a man if you gain the whole world and lose your soul? What shall it profit you if you have all the land, all the cars, and all the houses, and you die and go to hell? Because I'm looking. I see the casket. I saw Tavis, but I don't see a U-Haul. And whatever Tavis owned, he couldn't take it with him. And the day is going to come where all of us got to stand before our Maker. Mama can't stand in judgment for you. Grandmama, granddaddy can't stand in judgment for you. You got to stand for yourself. So don't put it off. Because I come to tell you about a man. His name is Jesus. Mary's baby. God's son. Lily of the valley. Bright and morning star. I come to tell you about a man named Jesus. He's a friend that stick closer than a brother. He's a mother when you're motherless. He's a father when you're fatherless. And I come to tell you, if you taste him, you'll see that he's good. He's not good sometimes, but he's good all the time. So don't put it off. Get to know him while you can. Some of you here, you're in the crowd, but you're lost. You're in the crowd, but you don't know Jesus. If Tavis was here right now, he would tell you, don't put it off. Don't think that you can get it right later. If you died tonight, where would you go? Because if you don't know, that is an answer. But when you come to know Jesus and experience Jesus as your Lord and Savior, you'll realize that he would be better to you than you can be to yourself. Don't put it off. You can come just as you are. I don't care what you did last night. I don't care what you did this morning. Jesus says, whosoever will, let him come.
So I'm going to stop right there. Don't bother y'all to come on, but I'm going to stop right there. If there be somebody here, you know you need to get your life right. You know you need to come over on the Lord's side. Don't put it off. Don't worry about what people are going to say. People have no heaven or hell to put you in. But if you died right now and you didn't make Jesus your Lord and Savior, saints, you're hell bound. So if there be one here today, if you want to make your Tavius happy, meet me down here. Don't put off today. But you can, don't put off tomorrow what you can do today. Saints, come right now. Somebody, you need to come and give your life to Christ. This is your opportunity. Don't put it off. Don't put it off. Whosoever will, let them come. It doesn't matter about your past. Jesus doesn't do background checks. Whosoever will, let them come. Don't put it off. Today, if you would hear my voice, harden not your heart. Come on, Brother Parker. Don't put it off. Don't put it off. Jesus loves you just the way you are. You don't have to dress up. You don't have to fix up. Come just the way you are. And if you come like you are, we'll save you. Don't put it on.
Billows roll. Whatever my lot, thou hast taught me to say, it is well with my soul. The family of the late Mr. J. Tavis Haugabrook is most appreciative for all the many kind and loving expressions of sympathy shown to them during this time of sorrow. They ask for your continued prayers in the days ahead. May each of you continue in the blessings of the Lord. Flowers have been sent. With deepest sympathy, Pastor Haugabrook and the members of the Greater Gum Creek Baptist Church. With deepest sympathy, the Lewis family. With deepest sympathy, our deepest sympathy to the family of J. Tavis Haugabrook on behalf of the Dooley County school, track team record holders, Bentavious Miller, Kendall Hinton, Keith Mumphrey, Coach Barron, Coach Harper, may peace be upon you and the family. We love you. With deepest sympathy, we send our thoughts and our hearts and prayers are with you during this difficult time. Jasmine George, Michaela Williams. Forever loved and forever remembered, Melicia Sales, C and family. To the family from Pastor Cynthia Johnson and Team Destiny. With deepest sympathy, Mary Henderson and family. In loving memory of Tavis Haugabrook, may the love of friends and family carry you through your grief, Sheezy. With deepest sympathy, the class of 2011. Our hearts go out to each of you. We know Tavis will be sorely missed by everyone who knew him. He touched the lives of many people. We give our heartfelt condolences to the family and pray that the time will bring comfort and strength. We love you, Terry and family, Tony Antonio Smith of Lawrenceville, Georgia. With deepest sympathy, Aunt Karanika and Tony Clayton. With deepest sympathy, Shanita Collier Grace, Francis Lester Gardner, and Frankie Lee Collier and family. And the casket spray is given in loving memory from the Dooley County High School class of 2011. In loving memory of Dr. Napoleon Williams, Deacon Arthur L. Parker, CEO and President, and the J.W. Williams Funeral Home staff, we present to this family the African American Heirloom Family Bible in hope that it will serve as a source of added comfort and peace in the days to come. For scripture tells us that weeping may endure for a night, but joy cometh in the morning. The J.W. Williams Funeral Home family presents to this family a pictorial tribute of your loved one's life. It is our hope that you will forever remember the many cherished memories you've shared as a family together. May God bless you and keep you is our prayer.
Blessed are the dead which dieth in the Lord from henceforth, yea, saith the Spirit, that they may rest from their labors, for their works do follow them. As much as is pleased the Almighty God, in his wise counsel and infinite wisdom, to take out of the world unto himself the soul of our deceased brother, Tavis Haugabrook, we therefore now commit his body to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, and dust to dust.